Hi, in this video I'm going to have a look at the Killer Sudoku game by Sudoku.com. First, for those of you who might not be familiar with Sudokus, I'm going to give a quick explanation. So in a Sudoku, in the traditional Sudoku puzzle, you have just like here, a 9x9 cells, a grid of 9x9 cells, subdivided into 9 blocks of 3x3, and the goal is to fill in the digits 1 to 9 in cells with the restrictions that for each row, each column, and each block, all of the digits are only allowed to occur once. So, for example, you cannot put a 1 here because it would be a conflict with this one. You can also not put in a 6 here because it would be a conflict with this 6 in the same block. You can also not put in a 9 because it would be a conflict with the 9 in this column. Okay, the killer Sudoku has something extra, cages. So the dashed lines form a cage, and each cell is part of one cage, and the cages are not restricted to the same block, so they can go over blocks. So this one, this cage is partly in this block and partly in this block, and each cage has a sum as well. So for me, and maybe my eyes are not so good, but probably you can also not see this very well, especially if you're looking at this on a small screen, those summations are quite hard to distinguish. That's a bit of a pity. Actually, on my iPad where I play this game, this was very clear, so this is not really a drawback of the game, but currently I'm using BlueStacks to play it on my computer because that is a better way to make videos for me. But the there it is just very hard to distinguish. So that is that's a bit of a pity, I would say. Might be that I'm going to make some mistakes because of that, but we'll see. That was kind of a sidestep, but that is the way, the idea of the Sudoku. For killer Sudoku, all the same rules still apply as the normal Sudoku, but in addition we have this cages that give a summation. Well, this game has 4 different levels, currently playing at the second level, just for the illustration purpose of this video. And we can start by filling in things that we know. For example, well, this is already a bit hard to distinguish. I'm not going to, let's see. So this should be 14. We have already 8 in this cage, so we can add 6. Here it is 10. We have already 6 and 3 in this cage, so we can add 1. In this way, you can just continue at 12. We have already 8, so that becomes 4. We can just look at whether there are easy ones like 11. We already have 2, so the other part is 9. 22, we already have 15, so the other one is 7. I think this is 18, so that makes this 5. I'm not too sure what is located here. It's very clearly a 7, this clearly 11, so that becomes an 8. This seems to be 10, so that becomes 6. Looks a bit like 19, is it? Yes. Kind of guessing, which is not very good. So first you try to fill in the easy ones. I would say this is a 4. And this is a 10, so that makes this an 8. And then we have 2 left in this column, so you can start looking. We missed the 2 and the 9. Is there a way? Well, the 9 is already on this row, so that cannot be 9. So that should be 2. And then this becomes 9. Well, can fill in this one again. is 1, and then this one we should also be able to fill in as 7, because it is the total is 18. Now we have 2 missing from this block, that is 5 and 7. 7 cannot be here, so this should be 5, and then this is 7. Can see whether we can already find this one. 1, 2, well, I already see 4 is in this column. It's not here, so it should be here. 5 and 6. 6 cannot be here, so this should be 5. This should be 6. 1, 2. If I'm looking at this row now, we miss 3 and 5. 3 cannot be here, so this should be 5, and then 3 should be here. I didn't distinguish that this was a 3. This is a 6, I think, so that should be 1. And then we have 2 here. We can look at this row, and we miss 3 and 9. We don't know anything about that yet, so. And this one we miss 1. 1 should be here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 here. So that one is completed. This is 12. We have 8, so this should be 4. 14, we have 9, so this should be 5. And this is a bit difficult for me to see. 1, 2, say 17. And this should be a 9. And then we can do this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 8 matches with the 14 here. So it is quite doable, I would say, this puzzle medium. I have played a few times with Expert on my iPad 2 times, and I both times was able to complete that one as well. But I had to use the notes option. Huh? Sometimes you don't know, you know, okay, this is 11 and 6. Well, that we can have with 9 and 2, but we can also have it with 3 and 8 and 4 and 7 and 5 and 6. But the other cell can also contain everything. So you start like this, and then, but oh, 5, 6, 8 cannot be, so we can switch those off again. Well, 9 can also not be, because that's already in this block. And then for this, well, 3 and 7 can also not be. And this way, and this one is relatively easy, so it's really easy, but the other one you start with almost nothing known, and you have to deduce your way out of there if you go to the expert level. Where you can say 2, 3 is also not possible. So that works quite nicely, I would say. Of course, here it's not going to bring us any further. Well, we now know that this is 4 or 7, and this is 4 and 2, but this cannot be 4, because then that would be 2, and that is not possible. So it can only be this one 7, that one 4. So now, once we have done that, we can use that that logic to fill in the rest. So this was 14, so that should be 8. And now, yeah, we can also have a look at this one again. 2 and 5 we are missing, but that is okay. No way to deduce that for me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and 8 here, but then this should be 8, cannot be 4, and this should be 4. And then in this field we have 1, 2, 3, 4, we miss 5 and 6. 6 has to go here, and 5 has to go here. So now we have filled in all 8 ones again, so they disappear from the list, so we cannot make mistakes there anymore. That's nice. Here we should fill in a 3. And then we have a 2 and a 6 here. The 2 cannot go here, and the 6 cannot go there, so that's done as well. We have a 6 in this column and a 6 in this column, so the 6 should be here in this block, should be in this column. We have also this in this row, so this is the only field that remains. I think this is a 7, so let's put that there, the 1. And this is the only place for the 1 here. So this should be the 2. This is the only place for the 1 here, so the 1s are done. For 2 should be here because of this row and this column. 2 here can only be on this location. The 3s. Oh. It's easy to make mistakes here. So that's luckily we have some. And that is typical what I have done before when I was playing, like forgetting to select a cell before I click the number. In my mind, I had already selected it. And the other thing is that I forgot whether I had the notes on or off. So typically I have thought I had the notes on, but I had it off. And then I was filling a wrong one in a cell. This is 5, this is 7, four, five, nine, 3 and 9. So it's all quite quite easy to play, and actually on my iPad I thought it played very well. And you should of course not play this kind of game on BlueStacks. That's more for the serious games, not this one. You can do it just in between things, and I think on I haven't tried it on a mobile phone, but should look well there as well. I think there's just something a bit wrong, maybe with my settings, or maybe with the game is just not working well on BlueStacks. Graphically wise, it's just those digits are too small, and my eyes are also not that that good. But okay, I was still able to beat it. I hope that this gives a good idea how to play this this game and what it looks like. I think it's I give it 8 out of 10 stars. It's definitely, I think, a recommendation for people who really like Sudokus, of course, and this killer Sudoku variation. Of course, there is not that much variation in this kind of game, but you do have a new field each time, so it can offer you some fun if you like this kind of games. Anyway, thanks for watching this video, and if you have any comments or any questions, that's always much appreciated.